God, and I praise you this morning. We thank God for what we are about to experience and what we are about to have to worship. Are you glad to be in the house? Look at one more time. Oh, come on, church. We can praise God better than that. I'm glad to be in this house. I hope that you are glad to be in this house. But truly, truly, the word of God says, truly, when you come into the house of the Lord, there should be thanksgiving on your lips. There should be praise on your lips. Let everything that happens well praise the Lord. I'm glad to be in the house this morning. If something has to wrap your praise, if something is wrong, if God got you up this morning, if he started you on your way, you are in the house for a reason. It is here to praise the Lord. It's not the form of fashion. It's not to look at what folks got on. It's something that I listen to. No, no, I dress on my way to the show. I got jeans and a jacket on. But it's no matter how they come into the house. It matters what praise you bring it into the house. Don't just say we thank God for what he's about to do. Today is our trustee annual day. Amen. Amen, amen. So with that, I'm going to step aside. Let me let you know we are recording on Facebook Live, so our worship will be streamed. If you want to text somebody and say, you can't be here, visit us on our site on Facebook and join us for worship. Amen, on today. Amen. Sister Miles, be here for a script. It's going to come. It's going to kick off our annual day for our trustees. Amen, in proper fashion. Amen. Amen. In proper fashion, amen. First and foremost, I want to thank God for Brother Joe Collins who is helping us in here on the word today. Amen. And as they process to you, amen, our trustees of First Mountain Missionary Baptist Church, as they march in, Brother Collins asked for just a little, amen, praise music as they march in, amen, and process in on this morning. Amen. Thank you. take you in faith, because you are the one that has done this for us. Could have been a little way, Lord. We just want to say thank you again. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. I don't know what else to say, but say thank you for what you have done for us. Bless each and every one. Give us your grace. Give us hope that we need, as long as the faith that we need.
salvation, you're more than willing to join in with us. Because we have come from a long way the past 18 months. And God deserves our praise. And what he says is, my hallelujah belongs to me.
Thank you. People may change.
But God never changes. Now we're going to have one of the greatest things in the church.
Y'all on my page.
Okay.
Thank you.
seven members is called Church Hall. We will continue supporting our graduates. We are now asking for donations to build up scholarship funds to complete the Hamilton Church. This is our announcement. Have a great day. Again, first my side.
You know, you did my one time on the Mr. Banner. You're very good to be down here. I'm going to move on. First my side, I would say it's appropriate to send you cards. But I look up. Last Sunday, I saw the first man lying. Press your way, an hour away, just to see me, or hug me, or touch me. It did touch me. But I call my past, the past that I need you. He said, of course, I'll be there. Pastor, I want you to know that South Carolina is ringing my phone. You're texting me. And talking about you. It's okay. What he said was, you bless this all. He can thank Pastor. I know him in the heart. I know you showed up. Did you thank him? I had a call this morning to remind me that my niece is South Carolina, as you know. He can come down here and say it anytime. I want you to come. Thank you for my mind. You express your thoughtfulness and your kindness in many ways. Give you my hearing. Cards. Text. Phone calls. Yesterday, when Sarah called to check on me, I was sleeping. My body was catching up saying that yes, you did. For 3 years, my husband was passed on down here 3 years. And I can't take him 3 years. But it didn't matter. Every Sunday morning, this is when church started back. Now I had to see him in the car the last Sunday, prior to our coming back in church. I had a dream, and I became obsessed with it. If Mama was here, she could tell me what the dream is. But I couldn't sleep. I could see it all through a clear face. I could see it all through him, see through me. And he looking back at me with a smile. At last, at last Sunday morning, because he went to church that Sunday and I went to the night. And I told him about the dream. I told my son about the dream. I said, oh, Lord, I don't know. Something's going to happen. I don't know what it is going to happen. He had usually every day, 7 days a week, he went to the restaurant with his buddies to eat breakfast. I called it Breakfast Club. He left the house dressed to go to church, and I was on my morning walk. I couldn't kick it. His mother said, I don't want to go out there. I told that man, I'm not going down there. I'm going to watch my pastor on TV. I'm not going down there. And he said, wrestle with me. And I told him I was not going to go. And he made me pick up the phone, call the restaurant, and come back and get me. Don't ask me why, but come back and get me. I'm going to the church. When I stepped in the church and said, I don't know why you're here. I dreamed I'd be here, but don't get attacked. My church starts next Sunday. Because God wanted me to spend that last Sunday in church. And I did. Went to Dr. Trustee, young and twisted, but his condition, Trustee told me everything looked good. He would not have to go back to the hospital thing again. My son called mommy got fish tank. He wanted Sunday and wrecked some fish. We shared a box of crocus and fixes. A dinner sat down and watched TV and laughed and talked to 3 months and upstairs. In about 15 minutes, he called my name twice. The next thing I know, he was on
ask me to do whatever anyway. I sit in prayer. I love that song. And most times I express myself through the song I do. What did you miss last Sunday? And people asking me, how can you dance at your husband's funeral? I express myself. I can't take a man for 3 years. I don't have a yield. Now I've got to get first my sign. And first my sign, I'm back.
Keeping and saving power. Amen. One of the things I learned, Sister Ma, especially me and Kester Jones talked afterwards. And the preachers talked for a long time. You know this preacher talks for a long time. Amen. Amen. Y'all laughing. Amen. I wanted y'all to laugh, but I could laugh. I don't know what I'm talking about. Amen. But one of the things that Reverend Jones said, and it really got to me, it really stuck with me, he said, what I hear out of what Sister Ma was doing, sometimes you just gotta worship the way verdict. I hope that helps somebody. I hope that helps somebody today. Because you're not just here at first my time for more fashion. Somebody brought something here. You brought a trial, a tribulation, an issue, a problem. And the pastor doesn't need to know about it, but what else needs to know about it? But you know about it. God knows about it. And whatever that is, worship your way through it. Because sometimes, I believe when you begin to worship, God begins to give you answers and clarity that doctors can't give, the psychiatrists can't give. God begins to give you answers in the midst of worship. So I want to say to Sister Ma, we understand and build you. You're just worshiping through it. You're worshiping through it. And we need to maybe worship all together. Because all of us are more than something. Amen. 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 We celebrated our trustees annual day over there. Let's give a hand clap of praise. Amen. For that all today. Amen. But just a few reminders. Amen. Those are my special Facebook Live as well. Amen. There's various ways of which you can give. By way of Gilify and PayPal, amen. You see on our Facebook Live, you can see everything that's there. Our Gilify app, you can go there as well as be able to give as well for our tithes and offerings. Always a reminder, because you always have to keep in mind that we are on the social platform. So sometimes gifts come other than us passing the plate here. The plate gets passed, amen, just by saying something and somebody reaches to their phone and actually gives it. So, with that, we just thank you for your gifts to First Baptist Baptist Church as God continues to move forward. God will continue to give us what we need. Sister Marissa Davis gave us our announcements. I'm not going to go through all of those, but please be reminded that if you need announcements to the church, please contact the church. Amen. The church secretary will make sure to get those added both on social media and to our call posts. My goal is to make sure I'm getting at least one call post out a week. Sometimes you'll hear two because of just communication and information. If you are not getting the call post, please let us know. Because that means there's something on our end that we're not doing, and we need to make sure that you're added onto that list so that you're getting those call posts. Normally, social media on our Facebook page as well as call posts is our main modes of communication outside. For personal outside. So if you're not getting the call posts, if you're not getting from social media, then you're not getting it. You're not getting that information. And we need to make sure as a member of personal outside, you are getting whatever communications that we have going forward. Also, amen, I want these three individuals to stand. Amen. Brother Kenny Floyd, this is Melissa Adams.
Amen.
And Brother Willis Ware.
Amen.
Amen. I want you to give a round of applause, amen, for they are your new deacons, amen. And first of all, I'm sorry to say that's the church. Amen, amen. Let's give a hand by the praise, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. They went through a very rigorous process. Amen. With pastor, I do not take the active ordination lightly for deacons or ministers. So they went through a process and completed it on yesterday. Amen. And so in the future date, we just have to get with all their families, with them and their families, and make sure that we agree upon a thing. There will be a service in the future. Hoping we'll be in August, and not August, we'll be in September. But we will have official service in order to graduate them as a formal service, a part of the celebration of what they have gone through, and also this aspect of achievement with regards to being looked upon amongst the membership, amen, and being able to lead from the standpoint of being a diaconate, which means deacon, amen, in Greek. So with that, I would just thank God for them and what God's going to do through them. If you see them, just congratulate them, and it's all right to say Deacon Ware, Deacon Floyd, and Deacon Melissa Adams.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. We thank God for them and what they are continuing to do in our midst. At this time, again, I don't have my program in front of me because I've been running and I can get stuff. Amen. So I have it in my mind. So I know someone will be coming to give recognition of our sick and our shut-ins. I want to thank all of our ushers who post on the floor. Amen. For Emmanuel Wilson, and everyone who's back with the sound and sight. Amen. Again, Brother Joe Collins, who's on the board. Amen. Everyone who's here on the floor, on the drums, also our choir for today as well. Amen. Thank you, Mr. Clark. Amen. So, with that being said, these are all reminders for this week. There's nothing else. I'm going to make sure there's nothing else that we will now have on the aspect of our sick and shut in. And then afterwards, we will have prayer by Deacon J. Adams. Amen. Sister Mary, April Mary will come and give recognition, special recognition, and then at this time, and I'm loving this. Amen. Thank God for these screens. Amen. Amen. Look at this. Just look around. I was happy. There's one behind you, too, just to let you know. Amen. But I'm seeing the artwork, and so it brings life to the church. Amen. 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 That's trusting this evangelist. Amen. First time I was on the logo, I'm looking, I'm like, it looks so churchy. Just make you want to shout for Jesus. Amen. Amen. I'm sorry, I'm in my kids' zone right now. Amen. Amen. But we thank God for this blessing to take this little stuff. Sister Mary.
May God bless our hands and our hearts, that our differences may find peace.
Just click that app. Once you click it, go to Personal Time, straight back to church. You will see our logo. Just give to our church. Amen. That way, God will lead you to do so. Amen. For those of us not dialing, amen, during the course of the week, we do have a drop box on the side door, which is locked during the week. We make sure you give that drop box, actually, tithes, offerings, in the envelope that way, amen, as well. So we want to make sure we open those avenues up to you, also here in worship, to be able to give unto the Lord. Amen. Every time Mary and Brother Tim will, they will come at the time, amen, to let tithes and offerings at this time. Please remember first about time, family and friends. If you wish to give when you first come to worship, the masses are always to the back, and you can actually give when you come in. But if you miss the giving part of our service, you can give when you leave. So we make sure to actually have the after Bible doing this, just to make sure that things are safe in the midst of where we are. Amen. The Delta variant is trying to wreak its hand, amen, but the devil is alive. Amen. And so with that, we are continuing to make sure we have cautionary measures. Amen. Outside, you see, we set hand sanitizer that we have, things that they can try to make things safe for everyone. Also, to everyone, make sure when we leave today, amen, that you do not walk out the same way you came in. We want to make sure that you go outside the side doors. Why is this, Pastor? Because we just want to make sure, again, it's a cautionary measure of keeping folks safe during the midst of this COVID-19 pandemic. Amen. Things will get better over time, and we believe that they will. Amen. But we want to make sure that we're going to have a safe worship experience. We want to make sure we're taking safe measures in being able to do so. So at this time, let us have a word of prayer as we pray over the giving of our tithes and offerings. Let us pray at this time. Most eternal, righteous God, we thank you for this time of giving, O Lord, the portion of stuff which you've given to us in the form of tithes and offerings. Thank you for this trustee annual day and the celebration thereof. We ask, Lord, that Lord, you bless us, Lord, with the mindset to be givers, O God. Because, Lord, you've given us so much. We thank you, Lord, for what you've already done, but also, Lord, what you want to do through us in the midst of giving, O Lord, to first down time, O Lord. We're just trying to restore, renew, and rebuild you to serve the kingdom of God, and doing that in order to exalt the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Savior. Bless us every way, Lord, and give us what we need. God, we ask that you bless those who don't have to give but have a heart to give, O God. God, we just bless those who have to give, O Lord, and are giving freely and cheerfully. God, that everything that will be collected, O Lord, the contributions will be used to upbuild the kingdom of God in this place called First Mountain High. God, you bless us enough already. God, we know that you'll bless us even more if we're obedient to you. Bless us now and keep us in every way, and we'll be careful to give you that praise, honor, and glory. It's in your Son's name that we pray. Jesus the Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. more than further to our program, amen. I always want to give recognition, amen, because we would not sit where we sit, amen, if it wasn't for those who came behind us and put in the energy and the work and able to do it, amen. So, Sister Owens, how you doing? She is here in service today? Thought she was in service. She's not. Amen. But she was in service last week and I missed it. Amen. But I always want to do that, amen, because last time she was in the service. And so I thought I saw her on today. And continue to be in prayer for Sister Owens. Amen. Continue to, she's still connected to this church. Amen. But what you see, amen, what you see was, again, because of Dr. C. Owens and Sister Owens, amen, the ministry for years in this church. I always like to make sure that I honor those who, amen, show that we stand on in order to continue to do the work based off what God has given them. Because remember, we're just building, amen, upon others who were building before. Amen. We thank God again for the worship, amen. We'll continue with our program at this time. Amen. And we have a song right now. But I'm sorry, let me let you fail and you come back.
I'm coming.
Otherwise, I will hear about this again. Amen.
Mm-hmm. North and South Carolina. Other areas of ministry include Thank you.
here, amen, for us to send that post, amen, for the media people, amen, because nowadays we have to put media because on Facebook, and on Zoom, we can see the worldwide, we have to show that social media attendance and be in tune with social media, amen. I'm so proud to have to say yes and handle Trustee Day appreciation or acknowledgement of what happened because it's so important to be acknowledged that people work so hard and diligently working with the bad men. Sometimes some of your trustees do behind the scenes and you're not there to meet the time when they're going through some tough negotiations and stuff on your behalf. Amen. Sometimes you like it, sometimes you don't like it. But when you step aside in time, to get them handy today, that's a point and that's a start in that time. Amen? Amen. So if you're turning your Bibles, your iPhones, your cell phones, whatever thing you have, you have to bring God through the shoes, lace, or the shirt tail, amen. Turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 4. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, beginning in verse 1. Amen. Amen. Word of God for the people of God. And I'll be reading from the King James Version this morning. That's 1 Corinthians chapter 4, again in verse 1. For many of you, if you're standing in the presence of God, I would greatly appreciate it. And I would give God the knowledge and the words being spoken to people to give their peace to Him. Amen? Amen. If everybody has found it, amen, just peace them for us. Just give me the Holy Spirit of God. Let a man so account of us as the ministers of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Moreover, it is required as stewards that a man be found faithful. Amen. In God's reading of his own word, you may be seated. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we come this morning to open up to your people the word of life. We thank you for this congregation. We thank you, Lord God, all that you do. For the Karen and the Spirit and the people here in worship this morning. As we open up the word, oh God, we seek, oh God, to anoint this text, as you anoint this text with your strength and your might. Anoint it in such a way, oh God, that your humble servant might proclaim it in clarity and conviction. Anoint it with such might, oh God, and strength that each word will be received by your servant today and those that are listening. And oh God, we become obedient and doers of the word. Our prayer is that it will be done this day here at First Mount Zion Missionary Baptist Church as it is in heaven on high. In the powerful, matchless, precious name of Jesus Christ, we do pray. Amen. First of all, I'd like to start off with some simplicities here about the general activities of the trustees. Trustees, in most cases, in all cases, in most states, or wherever they may be, are required by law that any 501c3 or any other organization have a board of directors, and we know this all in trustees, but they can be deacons also. But trustees are required by law to handle the business of the church. Okay? That does not take them over, under, or in between the word and the gospel of Jesus Christ. They are there as co-workers in the ministry. Amen? The law requires that they have a responsibility. They have a fiduciary responsibility to take care of the church and congregation according to God's will, first of all, and His. God is put to handle things that happen in the secular world that have a profound effect on the spiritual content of what the church does, the church culture does. So they are guardians of God's word, but amen, all of those things that the secular world brings to their being. So they need to be a steward in certain rules and regulations to make sure they understand what they're doing in order to help you carry out the ministry of Jesus Christ. Amen? Then, on the other hand, they're always trying to create and give other organizations in the church, such as the deacons, deacons by
a group of individual people performing things that the church calls them to do. Their responsibility is to carry on the church. Their job is not to change the life of the bishop, like those big change, amen?
Amen.
Now, I'm not going to tell you this morning about all the duties and responsibilities of the trustees, because you see them all the time, amen? I'm not going to tell you they ought to be above reproach, amen? The trustees ought to be good to the godly individual, they ought to be blameless, they ought to be within a ministry of leadership that stands above everybody else, amen? They ought to be spiritually obedient to the word of God. I'm not going to tell you that, amen? talked about it, and I was in class, and going to class. We did the sixth grade boys class. Now, Sunday school class was on the Old Testament. After listening for a while, the preacher decided to, you know, miss a little catch. You know how that preacher, we want to catch the business of the word of God. Amen. And he said, who knows who knocked down the walls of Jericho? Two little boys quickly asked him, preacher, we don't know who knocked them down, we didn't. Display of biblical illiteracy, amen. I was talking today, he had some cause tonight. Amen?